quality food. And our seniors deserve better. And when you look at all the networks of the Food Depot and the Roadrunner and the food banks all over the state, the churches, the advocacy groups, it could be a small group handing out sandwiches in a park. It could be a group handing out bags of food to immigrants who don't want to really be identified. Let's take care of everybody. We also have had this task force on grandparents raising grandchildren, but we have expanded some of the language to many people taking care of grandchildren. It could be aunts and uncles, like I was, taking care of somebody. It could be a next door neighbor who really cares about that person. It could be a niece taking in a niece. But we really want to support the extended network that's necessary to take care of our children. And bless you for doing what you've done with your grandchild. It's very hard, and I appreciate everything that you went through, all the struggles. The backpack program should not be discontinued. If you're associated with a group that's been working on that, please keep it going. I think that there are a lot of other individuals who could contribute to projects like that, so we just need to advertise it. I also know that some of the groups are now collecting food for pets of people who cannot afford to go out and buy pet food. And they themselves are getting food for themselves, and now we're trying to help them keep their pet in their own homes. I know that there's so many great efforts going on, and the more we all can collaborate together and keep saying poverty and food needs, I know everybody has their other issues that they talk about. But you gotta keep talking about it. If people don't talk about poverty, they don't talk about the need for food. So thank you very much for the work you do, and let's keep talking about it.